Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the Azure Seas of Glau. I am the Reizmeister, and this is episode 8 of From the Depths, the Glau campaign. I'm here in the designer on board my medium bomber prototype, which is painted now, and not a prototype anymore. I will assign a name to it, and I'll continue to use this little bomber in the campaign. I think it looks alright, it performs alright, well, so long as it doesn't get swamped by missiles, of course, and get blown to pieces, but yeah, that's another problem entirely. Anyway, with that being said, let's head on into the campaign. Alright, this is the situation in the campaign. In the last episode I managed to clear out a few tiles, but I accidentally pulled the garrison from another tile towards my forces, which is now blockading my transport. A minor inconvenience at best, as I have also found the HQ of GI Corporate, although I think I've found it for quite some time now. Anyway, my radar satellite has revealed that another force from Twilight R&D is heading towards me, and the end of the map is already in sight. So, let's see what we have here. Those are mostly... those are all air units, or hover units in case of the mining laser, so I shall counter them with my own. Let's see if I have retrofitted the correct... No? There we go. There seems to be something missing. Yeah, those are all right. The Phoenix Interceptor is... has not been constructed yet. I've not decided to spend resources on this just because it's a little bit too expensive for now. Okay, yeah, you may now engage. Okay, let's see. I should be able to have the upper hand here, as there are no, what are they called? No swarmers around, you know, those missile spewing... what are they? Helicopters? Yeah, probably helicopters. Although this is a far-fetched definition since... let's call them air units. This is a more general description of their behavior, since they're flying, yeah. Why are you altitude 1000? No, please. Don't go to the moon and back, just... stay a little bit there. Alright, I'm on the medium bomber prototype. Rain is pouring down, and let's do this. Battle begins. And hopefully, I'll come out on top. Okay, decoys are away. This is a good sight. I'm being assaulted by a mining laser. Please stop that. Yep, those are my tracers, by the way. Good hits on the target. Mining laser has some minor problems now. It seems that the laser part has been shot off. And once again, APM bombs happily define gravity, of course. Not defining, defying gravity. Yeah, okay, looking good so far. My Griffin Bomber Mark II is also engaging, though missing apparently, which is unfortunate. Okay. Oh, by the way, have you noticed the storm in the background? Yes, it's once again, this time in Glau, when there's a big and noisy storm happening. Now, this is interesting. In the last episode, one of my disabled fighter aircraft, was the Albatross, was being dragged behind by the hauler. Now, due to the strong propulsion I installed on the medium bomber, it's the hauler that is being dragged along. So the tables have turned. Yeah, the Albatross in the last part was part of the Flying Circus, a little experiment I made, but yeah, they are not very effective against missile spam, I've noticed. They are also meant as a reliable starter unit. Starter unit as in when you start the Quest for Nita campaign, so against the Deepwater Guard maybe. Also, I need to deactivate the balloon deployers. Oh, watch out. Yeah, right, you have a tail gun as well, don't you? Where is it? There it is. And not firing yet. This is unfortunate. So, we'll see the battle from the perspective of one of the bombers now, and I noticed that once again the high-altitude bomber has been gutted. Yep, spewing out its payload, and those mountains are actually very dangerous for my flying units, as they, well, they should stay a certain distance above the ground, but with these jagged rocks and tall mountains, it's sometimes difficult to maintain the correct altitude or to adjust for any changes in the terrain. Well, with that being said, I guess they manage quite good so far. Now, let's see this thing prove me wrong. No? Okay, I'll take it. Another mining laser defeated, another hauler on the field. No, you're flying. Doing alright. Throwing out flares and decoys. Oh wait, no, flares are decoys. Yeah, of course. Ignore me, please. And the Sword in the Wind, of course, doing bombing runs as well. Though this thing shouldn't have any problems with the terrain, since it will always stay at a very high altitude. And even in hover mode, it will still keep a reasonable distance from the terrain. Okay, battle has been finished, and I would like to pull my forces out of this stormy area. By the way, how fast are you? You are ridiculously fast. Okay. Yeah, this storm is actually getting on my nerves now. What did I do to deserve this? Seriously. The weather isn't even clearing up. Storm's getting worse. So in this case, I'll simply destroy the corporate HQ over here. Is there any way to silence the storm a little bit? Nope, doesn't look like it. Okay, well, until the weather clears up a bit, although it seems the rain is stopping. No, wait, it isn't. Oh yeah, looks like the weather is clearing up. Nice. And I thought I would never get out of this stormy area. Yeah. Partly cloudy, with a chance of destruction as I assault the the second corporate HQ with my seaborne forces here. Let's see, my corvettes are first. Receiving. Then a few more of my corvettes, and the Moorays take the last place in the spawn order. I've noticed that the Moorays are terrifyingly effective, by the way, in disabling enemies. Okay, battle has been set up, and I still can't see the outlines of my ships. Doesn't matter though. Let's do this. Corporate HQ, you're on. But first I have to get through the defenses called the Doom Cannons. Those are nasty railguns. I hope my ships can disable them in time before they do too much damage. Oh. Yeah, that's about right. Okay, how are we that was close. How are we looking here? Quite nice actually. Just a few minor damage, hits on the secondary weapons. Received some minor damage so far. You are about to make landfall. Not a thing I would suggest when you are driving a waterborne craft. Now please be a good boatie and avoid the landfall. Ah, you just beached yourself. Okay. Oh no, wait. This could be a very terrible place to make a landfall, as the corporate HQ could spawn in right on top of those little corvettes. Anyway, these are now my new amphibious assault ships. They are so long amphibious until they have to go on land. Then they become stationary. That's my way of adapting to this situation. Okay, next loop cannon destroyed. And the corporate HQ is now on the field. Well, at least those decoys are working fine. Okay, you are not hitting the target properly. You're not much use of me now. Use to me now, since this is self-explanatory. Though I have to admit, I overestimated the AI's capability in avoiding any land. I have set up the AI correctly to avoid land, though this doesn't always work, as this little corvette here is about to prove. Wonderful! And now, what will you do now? Yeah, that's a fine situation you have gotten yourself into. Okay, let's see. How close am I to actually taking over the space and maybe destroying the AI core? Oh, I can't seem to find it. Oh, it's in here probably. Yeah. This should be over quickly. Fear my amphibious assault force. No, just don't. It's taking command. Taking command. Alright. No, you are all on the correct behavior. All set to auto-engage in combat, and I'll just have a look and see if this, what's it called, the Petrum corvette will also try to get on land. Oh, you know what? I mean, maybe it's time for a little airship. I have constructed a larger airship. Yeah, I'm just a little bit at a loss for words here. I'll just leave this sad display. Oh, this is really sad. Okay, then. Looks like a completely defenseless corporate HQ is proving to be too much for my seaborne forces. Although I could have set them up a little bit better so that they won't go on land. By this I mean giving them movement orders around this little bay here. Okay, what are you doing? Anything but helping. Okay, let's finish this quickly. I have the Moorays here. Yes. And they will now spawn in once I pull these forces from... What are you doing? Okay, how are you even moving? I mean, those ships don't have internal propulsion like Daily Blades. And still, they're moving over land. And the Moorray is online and firing missiles. Very good. Let's bring in the second one so that I can finally finish this. This is taking way longer than it has any right to be, any right to do so. It's just a defenseless corporate HQ. The little rocket launcher here, this weapon got knocked out pretty much at the start of the battle, and yeah, there we go. Thank you.
Receiving. Moving now.
Yeah. Well, this was a bit odd.
Listening.
Griffin
moving
bombers,
out.
Move up.
Listening. Moving out.
Air Force,
receiving.
Move up as well, moving and out. Transport group has been
receiving.
Hopefully resupplied. Let's check resource settings. Yes, you have been resupplied. Okay.
Receiving, moving now.
Yeah, I'm still in the process of building up my submarines. Most prominently featured here, U-22, made by JRG, a subscriber and a viewer of mine, who has submitted quite a lot of submarines and aircraft as well as airships for my Mirror Universe campaign, and they are doing a fantastic job. Both in giving me a lot of problems when
moving
they're
out.
On the side of the Mirror Universe and
listening,
in actually
out.
Helping me defeat said Mirror Universe.
Moving out.
Yeah, this campaign
moving
is in German, though.
Moving now.
Okay, I can now afford to build another submarine.
Listening.
Though I cannot afford to be running away from this force too long. This should be... This should be doable, though.
Listening.
Okay, I think I'll just scrap this Phoenix Interceptor. Yes, I would like to scrap it. And...
Listening.
Have a seat Listening. Right there on the Griffin Bomber Mark III. Because I'm about to spawn a unit from the aforementioned JRG, and this unit is going to be... Where is it? The Adler, or Eagle in English. And I would like to have two of those. Those are... How should I put it? Yes, I see the rain. Fighter bombers? Yeah, they are fighter bombers.
Moving out. Listening.
I think they have remote-guided missiles as well. Okay, construct them now.
Moving out.
Okay. You are not constructing those aircraft. Why? Oh, there we go. Oh yeah, I forgot. The Murais have repair tentacles. And my radar satellite is doing a fantastic job. Yeah. By blockading the enemy. Nice. These are some really efficient delaying tactics here.
Moving now. Listening. Moving out.
I don't see a counter here in the corner. Is this thing bugged again? Unfortunate. Receiving. But what can you do?
Moving now.
Okay, maybe building two of those at once was a little bit
listening.
Although no, they are finished. And you know what? I may have only 80%, 81%, 82% of a U-22, but I'll engage in battle regardless. Okay. Surface fleet, you will get your chance to shine.
Receiving.
Hopefully you won't mess up like last battle against the HQ. That was rather embarrassing, I have to admit. Air Force. Yes, no, maybe. Let's do it like this with the Eagles. I should rename them though, force name, so that you can understand it actually. Eagle. No, wait. Yes, this has to be done now, right before the battle. There is no other point in time that would be better suited to do this. Yep. Okay. I think I'm ready. Actually, yes, I am ready. Ignis Corvette. I choose you to be my... Right. There we go. Those are the Eagle fighter bombers. Merrily flying around and firing missiles at the enemy. That is a submarine, of course. Good thing they stay at a distance, and the storm is once again raging across those seas. U-22 in the distance is submerging now and getting ready to engage this particle accelerator cannon equipped submarine. Once again, I would like to apologize for this lovely weather we are having. You're probably not able to hear anything from the fight. Actually, you know what? I do this now. Just All right. I wish you could turn down the volume of environmental effects. Then again, I'm playing in version 2.4.9, at least until the whole balancing mayhem has died down a bit, and well, at least until the balancing has received more reasonable levels and we have a stable balance for at least I'd say half a year, maybe? Yeah. Okay, fast assault craft once again spawning in the water. I have set the spawn height for these in the designer to be at 100 meters, but I guess they... yeah, and the artillery as well. This is really unfortunate. Those units are very well made, and yeah, props to the creators there, but... this spawn height issue is a bit frustrating. We seem to be having some lovely snowfall, kind of fitting for the season, since it is December after all. Okay, Lisa. Yeah, the Juggler is a surface vessel, no problems here, except for the Juggler, of course, who's getting blown to pieces. Though I think I've not shown those Eagle fighter bombers correctly. Let me just... yeah. Nice units, don't you think? At least I think so. Small, compact, and they would be perfectly suited to be carrier-borne aircraft as well. Okay. Are we finished? No, we are not. Thankfully, though, my little corvettes here have torpedoes. They are equipped with a bit of everything, except anti-air systems. Well, with the exception being this little anti-air gun, but this thing doesn't really count as an effective anti-air system, I might add. Battle finished, no problems here, and yeah, what happens now? U-22, at least the one I repaired or tried to build, has been repaired during the fight and actually looking good now. Yeah, the Flying Circus. Yeah, how should I put this? I mean, the units on their own are very good. The Richthofen as well from Demadog and my Albatross. Yes, I'm. Yeah. But let's just say they have put on a rather poor performance. So, in the light of the recent performance review, I'll be cutting down the size of this Air Force a bit. simply due to me needing the resources for other more, let's say, stronger units. I have heard that there is a certain helicopter currently being built that has intermeshing rotors and is a dedicated anti-submarine warfare unit, which once it has had its debut in the Glau campaign will be accompanying some of my ships into battle in other campaigns. But this is a story for another time. Now then, what do we have here? Juggler, assault craft, helicopter, juggler. Uh-huh. There we have helicopters. This is a job for not the always efficient Air Force, no. This is a job for... no, they have missiles. I mean, don't get me wrong, those little biplanes and triplanes are performing quite well, but against missiles they tend to struggle a bit. Though, you know what? Ah, why not? Where's my transport? I need some construction power here. I thought I could, since I have now entered an area with silent snowfall.
Moving out.
I'll just get my Griffin bombers to be blockaded and construct the Richthofen.
Moving out.
Rather quickly now. And he has been constructed. No, he hasn't. Abort, abort.
Moving out. Moving out. Listening.
How long do you think I can kite this unit? I mean, this force here. Yeah, it's a shame though that despite having changed the spawn height of those units, they always spawn at the height of the flagship, which in this case is the Juggler, a surface vessel.
Moving out.
Oh well. Let's just get this over with. Yeah, this should be sufficient. Yep. You as well. Okay. And you. And of course, the nobleman himself. I'll be taking the pilot seat. And let's have ourselves a battle. Engage. Wonderful! We have a partially submerged fast assault craft. We have taken damage. Okay. Looks like those. I am a very fragile robot, apparently. Come on, drop pod. Wait, what has happened to my bomber? Why is my Air Force once again falling out of the sky? It's probably those helicopters' fault. Yeah. Yes, this is a problem with having no missile defense at all.
Engaging now.
Yeah, but you know, you can't always win. There has to be a day when you will eventually lose. Missiles hitting home. Okay, yeah, let's just do this, and once again, a rather disappointing performance from the Flying Circus, but this is partially due to my fault, since I have spawned them in incorrectly against far stronger units, far stronger than they could ever handle. Yeah. Okay, you are very dead, my friend. I think I should retire the Flying Circus for now and maybe bring it back at a later point in time. Also, there's a little laser being annoying.
Engaging now.
Engage this one. Alright. I have decided a tactical retreat is in order, and I will now engage with my other Air Force. But what happened to my medium bomber? This was very unfortunate. Looks like it got blown up quite good. Always being on the winning side would be boring, after all. Okay. Second Air Force, it's your turn now. Okay, good. Southern Wind is on the field. Something just exploded, and it was the helicopter. Good riddance, you annoying menace. Although I shouldn't be the one being angry here. This was entirely my fault, since I have not equipped my air units with any countermeasures. What happened to you? This doesn't look very healthy. Could it be that you received some torpedoes? Yeah. A few torpedo strikes. Yep, there they are. I just saw them. Wait. Or did you? Yes. Torpedoes.
Engaging now.
Please engage this one. I will pull the Griffin Bomb out of play for now. Well, if this keeps up, I might have to bring in my submarines as well. Well, you won't be able to see much of the battle, I assume. Laser, you are being annoying, despite being in the water. This should considerably weaken the laser beam, I assume, though. Yeah, I have no idea what's going on, actually. Missiles from my fighter bombers are going where they shouldn't. Oh, right. They are equipped with retro reflection sensors to guide their missiles towards their target, and I assume you do not. You have a retro reflection sensor. This is fantastic. There are no detection systems left to accurately home in on those. No optical ones, at least. Yeah. In that case, I'll just cram bomber. No? Okay. You know what? Where are my... There we are. Goodbye. Cram bomber. There you are. Griffin bomber Mark 1. The old and reliable version
engaging now
of my Griffin bomber. What has happened to the sword of wind? A sword in the wind. I guess its propulsion is out of balance. Not looking good there, I assume. This is due to some damage received by the laser. Yeah, it's a Bombay got shredded. Okay. Minor progress, but progress nonetheless. Sprite Fighter. Actually, I could, you know what? You fought well. You... Oh, okay. Yeah, I may have to overthink the concept with these eagles, since they rely on retro-reflection sensors that JRG has placed. I should always have a little guidance unit that provides detection for them in battle, I think. Oh, okay. Yeah, the flying circuits is lost. Unfortunate, but what can you do? Submarines, engage. Yeah. This is not very effective, but let's do this anyway. Torpedoes are out. Torpedo interceptors are out as well. And submarine U-22 is diving to its designated depth. Okay, where's the enemy? There it is. Still battered and combat ineffective, though this laser is really annoying. How did you dodge that? Oh yeah, by having a bigger target, of course. Yeah. Making a mental note here, next time use more submarines. They are effective. Very much so. Okay, you are dead. You are very dead. Lasers. Yeah. Alright. One juggler left. Though it's getting shredded already by the torpedoes that were already in the water. Interesting. Yep. Big explosion. another one, and another hit, and a few missiles, because why not? Battle finished. Yeah, this has taken a toll on my forces, mostly due to some faulty construction on my part, and yeah, I overestimated the combat capability of those flying circus. They have no missile defense after all. Won't do the same mistake a third time. No, I'd probably do it though. Bah, whatever. Okay, repairs please. Repair my units. Submarines and surface fleet. They can move towards the edge of this tile, and I'll just have a quick look at this radar satellite. What exactly is this? Oh, it's you. This is my little, combat capable satellite. I say combat capable, but it's a satellite that's meant to be deployed in combat as well, as it aids in relaying detection information for my units. You will be moved up a bit, and I'll get my transport group in there, repair a few units, and then I will spawn in a few more units here. Although this episode has gone a little bit longer than usual. Let's see. You are on the blaster bomb. No. This is a unit for another time. Nope. You are not meeting the volume limit, unfortunately. Let's see. Yeah, I'm looking for a certain unit, and I have forgotten its name. Ah, very unfortunate. There it is, the Longbow Bomber. A it's an aircraft built by Damadoc, which will be accompanying my other... the rest of my heavy bomber force. As heavy as they can get with the current volume limit, of course. Oh.
Lifting.
Yeah.
Moving out.
Let's move you over there. And let's build this thing. Alright. I'll just finish this and
lifting. Moving out.
Then this episode will come to a close as well. Goshenite Mountains. I have no idea what Goshenite means. I will look it up after this episode. Sodalite Mountain. Ocean. I can only assume this is some type of rock or mineral.
Listening.
Maybe, since it has the word light in it. And it's probably... yeah. This is the Longbow Bomber. You might be thinking, this slow-moving air unit is a heavy bomber. Yes, this one will fly to a higher altitude where its ion engines can be, let's say, more effective. And this thing will zip around the battlefield deploying its long-range cruise missiles located under the wings. And it also has decoys. Wonderful, isn't it? Anyway, with that, I'll say thank you all for watching. This has been episode 8 of the Glau campaign in From the Depths. I am der Heizmeister, and I hope I'll see you next time on the Azure Seas of Glau. But wait, there's more. Yes, I can't just finish just yet. I have a little announcement to make at the end of this episode. I will not be releasing any episodes during the holidays, since I will simply have no time to record. I will spend the time with my family, celebrate Christmas and New Year, of course. And new episodes will come out in January, I think. Yeah, they should. And yeah, that's about it. So, I hope you enjoyed. Take care and goodbye.